Hello everybody, I'm Dr. Pratima Shastri and I'm going to talk about food for health. Now, attitude towards food has been changing throughout the civilization. From food for survival, it has acquired a meaning in social and cultural aspect. With so many ingredients coming from agriculture, it also acquired food for pleasure, that means the food for celebration and pleasure. And this has led into so many problems. The food culture generally is harmonious with its surroundings, but with globalization, the culture has changed. Everything is available everywhere. And therefore, this situation is not in harmony with the lifestyle and the surroundings. This has led to the question, what is good food and what is bad food? Now, let me say, each and every culture in the world has defined and identified good foods and bad foods. In today's terminology, wholesome food and junk food. But what is really wholesome food and what is junk food? So let's come to the question, what is wholesome food? The wholesome food is that which provides enough calories, and the wholesome food for individual is going to be different. For everybody, a wholesome food should provide enough calories. Along with that, it also should provide enough other nutrients like proteins, micronutrients, everything else. It should not stuff the body with undesirable chemicals. It should be safe and it should be healthy. In contrast, the junk food provides empty calories. That means the calories are there, the feeling of satiety is there, but the nutrients are not there. So, this wholesome food, what are the characteristics of wholesome food? Generally, wholesome food should provide 65 calories from carbohydrates, around 20 to 25 calories from fat, and 10 to 15% calories from protein. Again, it differs from individual to individual, but this is a gross description. Now, desirable thing is, out of the total carbohydrates, maximum should be complex carbohydrates, sugar should be minimum. Out of the total fat, maximum should be unsaturated fats and natural fats. Trans fats and hydrogenated fats should be avoided. Refined sugar should be avoided. It should contain more natural ingredients, so it contains more fiber. Highly processed ingredients, they would lose their nutrients, so they are undesirable. And at the same time, there should be minimum use of chemicals, additives, preservatives, etc. So, is there a clear-cut difference between wholesome food and junk food? Let me tell you, there is no clear-cut difference like a hero food or a villain food. It's a range of foods from wholesomeness to junkness. So, it's a spectrum of foods, wholesome foods to junk foods. We can divide it, say, broadly into three categories. The first category is the green food, that means which you can eat anytime, anywhere. There is no limitation. This is the traffic light division. Yellow food, which you must wait and watch, and red food, which you should use only occasionally for celebration. Please mind well, this has nothing to do with the real color of the food. At least not at all related to the real color. So, how do you know whether the food is green or yellow or red category? If you see the label of the packaged food and if you read it carefully, try to find out, there are few questions you can ask to yourself. Does it provide more than 550 calories per 100 gram? Does it contain more than 30% fat? Does it contain less than 5% protein? More than 30% added sugar? More than 5% salt? Does it contain refined flours? Does it contain saturated and trans fats? Does it contain chemicals and preservatives? And is it highly processed? So, if answer to more than 6 questions is yes, the food belongs to red category. If it is 4 to 6 questions, it belongs to yellow category. And if it is less than 3, then it belongs to green category. But mind well, it is not only composition, but the portion size and the frequency. Like potato chips, the recommended portion size is 30 grams, but you open an 80 gram pack, do you stop? So, portion size is important, frequency is important. Combination of junk food with other foods is important. Like French fries with a carbonated drink is red. French fries can be moved to yellow category if you combine it with a chilled milk. Or a chilled milk with khakra or something belongs to a green category. So, what is the answer? How do you go to the wholesome food. The four steps are: identify right foods, make your choice and combine it with other foods, and have right exercise, enjoy the variety provided by nature, have a happy meal and good health too. Thank you.